Hello, lovely people, and welcome back to the Distinct and Jovial podcast. My name is Dom, and I'm joined by a plethora of people, but first I shall introduce my co-founder, Jerry. How are you doing, Jerry?
Hey, Dom. Hi, everyone. Yeah, I'm good, thank you. I can't speak. I'm trying to speak too quickly. I'm actually nervous a bit because we've got so many guests on. It's amazing. But yes, I'm very good.
I'll let
you
introduce
Dom.
You introduced all the guests.
You want me to introduce? Okay, so, well, just before we do, I am actually nervous. What the hell? Right. How are you, Dom? I need to ask that before we go any further.
Yeah, yes, good. I'm good.
Good, good. I've really been looking forward to this for a long time. So I didn't think this was going to happen. So I'm going to introduce you all to three wonderful, wonderful people that I have known since I was, 14? 13? 14?
Yeah.
Roughly.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a long time.
It's only about 5 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right. We're all in our 20s now, and this is great. It's our first school reunion. So it is a bit of a school reunion special. So I want to introduce you to the wonderful Tien.
Hello.
Woo!
Woo! The wonderful Carey.
Hey.
And the wonderful Naaved.
Woo!
Hello.
Welcome to the Distinct and Jovial podcast. It's absolutely fantastic to have you on here. It really is. I've been excited because I know that you're fans. I know you've listened to, well, Tien and Carey, I know you've listened to every episode and given feedback and told me about how many laughs you've had. And so to actually have you as guests is just amazing. It really is. So
proper
thank
fans.
You very much.
Proper,
yeah, yeah.
Proper fans that have listened to every
definitely.
Minute.
Definitely.
I think we worked out. When somebody else said that to me, we worked out it was something silly like nearly 90 hours worth of content that you've consumed. So that's 90 hours of your life you're not going to get back.
Yeah.
So I'm very sorry.
Sorry about that.
I need to get out more.
No comment.
Thanks, love.
I'll just put the normal one. This will be episode number 34. It is the I've done a wrong burgundy again. It's the 21st of March today. It's the 21st of March.
Nice.
It is 7:30 in the evening. Oh, we've gone back to an evening podcast.
It's
episode number 34. And as I'm sure everybody will be appreciative, the views that we express on this podcast are strictly our own. They don't represent any of the companies that we work for. So that we can be free with our opinions. But I have said that I will happily edit out anything that anybody does or does not want to say. Even if that's you, Jerry.
No, thank you. You have bleeped me on the odd occasion.
Well, I'm still winning 2-1.
You are winning 2-1. I'm still gutted about that, you know. At some point, it's going to be 2-2 at some point. You do realise that, don't you? It's only a matter of time.
I think it will be. It won't be.
It will be.
So we'll go straight into it. We'll do food of the month. Who wants to go first with their go-to meal deal?
Why don't you decide?
Well, you volunteered there, Naaved. I think.
Yeah.
Nice, okay, guys.
Let's keep your mouth shut.
Never take a step forward. Always take a step back.
The longest blade of grass always gets cut first.
Yes, you're right. It just reminds me of Catch 22 in Yuzarian.
Yeah, exactly.
Always step back. So this is our favourite meal deal, right?
Yeah, so if you were to walk into Tesco's or an equivalent supermarket and you had that £3.50 meal deal, we have to get sandwich, a crisp or something like
a cookie thing,
and
like
a drink.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, well, I wouldn't go. If I was given the choice, I wouldn't go to Tesco. Okay. No. I have been there.
Hey, well, we're choosing retailers now. What the hell?
Oh. Let's go for the meal deal. But recently, KFC have launched their meal deal.
Oh.
And so, yeah, man. So you get a chicken wrap or a chicken burger with a pack of crisps. You know, Walker's Max.
That's a good size.
You can choose any drink you want. £5.49, what's not to like? All right, slightly more expensive than your £3.50. And I don't think Tesco do that anymore. I think they've pushed their meal deal properly.
I was going to say, it's probably not £3.50 these days, is it?
No, exactly.
The wonderful
so just move a decimal point.
Yeah, exactly. So funny.
The other way.
But yeah, I think that rocks. Absolutely rocks.
Oh wow.
The other one I do like is Co-op. I think they do good meal deal. Oh. I think their sandwiches are good. And you can get a choice of more drinks, and you know, you can get fruit, and you know, I think those two, they'll be my go-to if I had the choice. 9 times out of 10 I don't, so what, I have to go to Tesco. What can you do, man?
You're gonna get sued by Tesco now. You're gonna sue your ass.
Naaved's club card is going to be declined this evening.
Please scan your club card.
Though, I do my shopping at Tesco, so you know,
you just wait. Please scan your club card. Oh, sorry, your club card's not accepted. Oh, I'm sorry, your business is not wanted here. Oh, I'm sorry. Please call security.
So what do we think of that then?
Well,
what do we think of the case?
That was a curveball, so I didn't even realise. I like it.
It's very new.
There was no KFC near me, so. Ooh.
I don't really KFC.
No, that's a controversial opinion on the podcast already, right there.
No, I think we should just bleep that. Just bleep it. It's way too offensive to keep that in.
I'm not into the Colonel's special flavouring or whatever it's called. I find it a bit salty.
Fair enough, love.
I tried the Colonel's special sauce, but it was a bit salty.
Yes.
There you go.
Jen, you walked into that one.
I did.
You did.
But,
controversial opinion of the podcast right there. Just straight in, straight for the jugular. No holds bearing back on that one. I mean, I'm pretty blown away, to be fair, Naaved, because I did not realise that existed. So, and I'm very fortunate because the KFC is next door to the office that I'm next to. Jeremy,
Dom, there you go.
As you well know.
Yes.
So
you need to get on that. That is dangerous.
The thing is, though, for a meal deal, it's expensive because it is $5.49. And even Co-op's premium is a private. And that's if you're a member.
£49p,
how much
is a member?
It's still more expensive than Tesco's and Waitrose and Asda and all of them.
How much research did you do for this?
I was thinking you've been doing too much research.
No, it's like...
No, it's just I have eaten a lot of meal deals, I could be not.
In the Northwest region... It's about £1.20 cheaper than the Northeast region. And anyway, go ahead.
No, but I will say one thing. One of the reasons that I'm not a fan of the Tesco meal deal, on a serious note, is that when I was in court for divorce proceedings, the only damn place where I could get any food when they let us off for lunch
was
bloody Tesco.
Tesco's.
So yes, I could have the bloody meal deal in a car. Not good memories.
No.
Fair enough.
Traumatized by meal deals. That's definitely going to be the title of a short clip later on when I put these together. That is definitely how we're going
to
do
it. Every little helps, and they were just trying to help. But that's fine. I totally get it.
Oh, dear.
Oh, brilliant.
How am I going to compare this?
Oh, that's legendary.
Just don't even try, Dom. Don't even try.
No, I was thinking to myself, like, how do I, like, you know, and you're going to think I'm sad, and I'm going to reveal to everybody on the podcast as well. Like, I practice this, right? I practice being able to talk through different bits of the podcast that Jerry... basically so I can control Jerry and set him in the right direction, and I've got four of you that are fairly similar minded.
Love.
Dom, they're worse than me. You're in right trouble.
Oh god, yeah. Oh, yes, we are.
Whatever. You started with a Colonel salty sauce or recipe or whatever.
Well, yeah,
hashtag
it's just gonna go It's just going to improve from here. There you go.
Is it really?
No, it's not. It's just going to go further down.
Yeah.
Further down.
On that tightrope, which way are we going to go? Which way is the seesaw going to go? Tien, do you want to give us your meal deal choice?
Not really. This was really difficult for me. I had to ask my husband because I'm like, because I don't work in an office. I work in a school. We can't leave. So I don't generally do meal deals. I was like, what are they talking about? He was like, you know, when we get on the train, what do you eat? And I was like, Marks and Spencer's, little, what are those pigs called? Percy pigs, packet of those. That's fine. But he said to me, you have to pick something. So I said, essentially, I would probably only ever go for a duck wrap because I don't like bread that much. I'm a very fussy eater. This whole first section is a big problem. Then I'd probably have a peach Lipton iced tea. Nice. And then most recently, because of Carey and going to York, I have discovered paprika crisps, which I've never had before. So it probably be those now.
I'm like,
so there we go.
Yeah, fantastic.
Paprika crisps and a ham sandwich. Amazing.
Oh, well, we didn't do that.
It's a bloody good idea.
Not
that
yet.
Is a very good idea.
Next time.
Paprika crisps. I agree with the duck wrap. Duck wrap. Oh, that's... Now we're talking like proper like get my bang for the buck on the meal deal. Like get the most thing that's cost the supermarket the most amount of money to make while I'm here.
The most labour intensive. Yeah, hoisting me
duck
up.
Duck wraps. Just the name makes me think of Donald Duck. You know,
in a towel. In a towel. Duck wrap.
Best duck wrap ever. That would be. It's your birthday, but in Donald Duck accent. Don't you reckon that would do a lot? I reckon somebody's got to do that.
You could do that, babe.
What about Daffy? What's wrong with Daffy?
Can't do Daffy.
But I can't.
What's really scary is I have heard AI, as Jerry's favourite topic, AI taking over the world. I have heard AI where they set different singers to do, you know, songs that weren't theirs. So something like... I don't know, Master of Puppets sung by Stevie Wonder or something like that. But I have heard, I don't think it was Donald, I think it was Daffy Duck doing a rock song. I can't remember the rock song off the top of my head, but I've heard his voice been used in AI. So maybe that will be the next duck rap.
Oh my God.
Is to get like Daffy Duck AI to complete
to
a different... to do something by...
Do you know what?
Which rap?
Jimenez. M&S should just come here. We should get the rights, advertising, you know, sign up Donald, sing some 50 Cent.
Which one?
In the club.
In the club.
In the club. In the club. That'd be fine. Yeah.
In the club.
Sandwich.
In the club sandwich. Great minds. Great minds.
Unbelievable things. Who brought all these people together?
That'd be me.
You can blame Jerry.
Yeah, I can blame Jerry.
I've stated before, the podcast is Jerry's fault, you know. Therefore, all no reward chance. And all complaints can be handed to Jerry.
No chance. I just got the equipment. It was your idea. We agreed to do it. I got the equipment. Then that was it. It's too late.
Yeah. I believe you on that. We'd have to skip on the Donald Duck, unfortunately, because Disney would come down with their copyright harder than you can check.
Yeah, you've got a point there. But you know, we're talking M&S. You know, they could sign that deal.
It's not just any old duck. It's an M&S duck.
Yeah.
M&S duck. In a towel.
Obviously.
Yeah, and do you really like Percy Pigs still?
God, I love Percy Pigs.
Do you?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
I will pretty much eat all the farm animals that Marks and Spencer make.
Oh, God, yeah.
The pigs, the sheep, the little cows.
Yeah.
Love them all. The little fizzy tails, chop off Percy's tail, put a little bit of, like, sparkly sugar on it. Yum. Sometimes, if it's a long train journey, it's the pig's faces and his tails. There we go.
Don't blame me on that, love.
I'm a little bit nervous around you.
Caterpillar cake is the caterpillar cake.
Oh, God, yeah.
Toy. You know.
Yeah.
Is that Colin?
Bougie what is the, what is it down here.
I was going to say, what's it called from M&S?
Oh, yeah, because Colin is Asda, isn't it?
Colin.
Is it Colin? Colin. It is Colin. Colin is from Colin? M&S.
Not Cedric. Yeah. Not no. whoever else.
Cuthbert.
No.
Cuthbert.
No.
Cuthbert. Colin.
That one sounds more M&S.
Christoph,
that is brilliant.
I haven't met Christoph.
Which one's that one, Jerry?
I don't know.
That's just Jerry's head.
It's just me. I'm just like coming up with new cake ideas.
Is Colin it Christoph? And his friends.
Boys' names.
Yeah, just any boys' names. But you want to choose like the most yeah. random ones.
Any boy's name
beginning
with C.
Yeah.
Well, I can think of one that's Charlie Unicorn November Tango, but I don't think that'll be good.
No, that's not a good name for a cake.
That's the one from Australia. It's the man down under.
Caleb.
Oh, dear.
Caleb the Caterpillar. Cooper. Connor. Cameron.
Why
Carson.
Why are they all guys, anyway?
Charles.
Why are they all guys?
I don't
why
know.
Why can't there be Catherine? The Caterpillar.
Caspian. Coulson.
Casper. The friendly Caterpillar.
Cadmus.
I think you should do surnames, Jerry, because then you can start on your favourite one with Benedict Cumberbatch then, can't you?
Oh, gosh.
Benedict Cumberbatch. Yes. Love the variations of that name.
I think Marks and Spencer's did do a girl one. Like at Valentine's. I don't know what it's called.
Did they?
Yeah, I don't know. I just remember seeing like a pinkish one.
Connie, don't Tesco have a girl one?
Probably called like, I don't know, Catherine.
It's Connie is the M&S.
There is
one.
A Connie. There is Connie. A Connie.
Oh my God.
I just found one on MS. I just quickly Googled it, right? And it and this caterpillar is £45. Connie the Connie the giant caterpillar is £45. And it serves 40 people.
No, it doesn't.
There
we go. Caterpillar cakes say they serve something like 14. They don't. They serve about 6.
I can on my way to York next time.
This one says 40.
Yeah.
40.
Dom,
not
I've
1,
seen
4.
It. I've just seen that.
What?
That's crazy.
What
giant milk chocolate coated chocolate sponge roll filled with chocolate buttercream. That won't serve 40. No way. There's no way you're getting 40.
Five segments.
Yeah, for goodness sake. You're not getting 40 slices
no
out of that. Look at it sold 18 times in the last 48 hours.
Oh, that's rubbish.
That's crazy.
Oh, dear.
To me.
Yeah. All for your next trip to York.
Yeah.
I can see you now lugging on this giant cake now onto the train, sticking it in that, getting a table seat, sticking it in the middle of the table and just sat there with, like, knife and fork, just kind of slowly just eating
away. I just want to recreate that scene from Matilda.
Oh, Bruce
Oh,
Bob
right,
Chopper.
Yeah.
Which end would you start with, though? Or would you start
end.
In the middle
bottom?
And then? Would you? Oh, okay.
Bottom.
Why?
You can't eat his face. Then it's
exactly.
just a cake. You have to leave the face yeah. at the end, so.
you
oh, I leave the face because I don't like that bit.
Okay.
I can't. I'm not sure my brain could quite comprehend the discussion that just happened there. It's like asking. Oh, I don't know.
Sorry, Tom.
Burn the candle at both ends and then set fire to in the middle and watch it explode. Carey, should we come to your meal deal?
Can if you like. not very exciting. I would generally get a Max paprika crisps, as everybody knows. Mm. That's my little extra thing. I'd get an innocent bolt from the blue.
Oh, definitely. Love those.
Have to. I'm not really into carbs very much at the moment at lunchtime. So I'd try and get a salad if I could do. But otherwise, I'd just get some kind of simple, normal sandwich. ham, cheese, tuna, whatever's around.
Nice.
The Tesco nearest to me is full of students at lunchtime, so there's never very much left.
Yes.
No, it's right over the road from college, so that's where they get their lunch.
How can students afford to eat out every day? These are not normal students.
Because it's cheaper than eating in college, to be honest.
They need to go make a sandwich. Wrap it.
Well, yeah, but they can't do that, Tien. They don't know how.
Don't comment. That you brought up to you?
Yeah, that is that blue shit that I bought when you guys were in York.
Like some Star Trek, that one.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
It's like the blue milk from Star Wars, do you remember?
Yeah, but it's not
when he was with Aunt Peru and they were having blue milk.
Yeah, I know the one you mean.
Before the sand troopers turned up and killed everyone.
Yeah.
It's like that, bolt from the blue. Yeah. That's what they were drinking
in the 70s. What's in it?
Oh, I can't remember.
I'm going to look it up.
I know it's got blue spirulina.
I've got it. 4.5 pressed apples, coconut water, 15 pressed grapes, some crushed white guava, a dash of pressed passion fruit, squeeze of lime, and some vitamins.
Because there aren't enough vitamins in all the fruit that they
have. All the rest of the stuff, yeah.
No, we just need a bit more. You go, you know what's lacking a bit here? Just
more vitamins.
Vitamins.
Random vitamins.
Yeah. We need people to get
ones that are bad for you.
What's confusing?
I mean, why would they have to put vitamins in if they've generally been that innocent with their smoothie?
That's two court cases now. One for Tesco's.
Yeah, where are we going with this?
I think we should
ban from Tesco's. Don't buy innocent smoothies. Maybe.
Well, I'm a little bit annoyed with food descriptions, actually, because, you know, they call them innocent, then they add in there, right? That ain't right. And then Colin has no damn caterpillars in it. I actually thought I'd be eating some kind of bug cake.
Bug cake.
We can make you one. If you want one, we can make you one.
Would that be your go-to meal deal? Some form of, you know, bug in the cake. Future, when we all have to eat, you know, dried bugs.
Look at them. Come on. What's that about? That don't taste like bacon. Something's just wrong there. Trade descriptions, that's what I'm saying. Just get them
out. Oh, God.
So, not so innocent smoothie. Okay.
Yeah, not so innocent smoothie. Maybe not that's so innocent smoothie. Maybe that's a cocktail. That could be a cocktail brand made by the Innocent Smoothie Company. You're not so innocent smoothie.
Dom, you need to patent that like now. You need to take that to them. You need to just say, look, I was there first. You just pay me 5% of all sales.
Yeah, patent it.
Yeah, do it.
Patent it, yeah.
Do it.
Yeah.
Do it.
Someone else will.
Yeah, someone else will do that. Someone else will do that. That's the beauty of this as well. The thing that confuses me from the ingredients, by the way, is it says the innocent plus bolt from the blue, guava and lime juice. And I was just like, what makes it blue? I'm trying to figure out what bit makes
this
it blue.
It's spirulina, isn't it?
It's the vitamins.
Exactly. It's the
it's the blue colorant that it's you can't put in anything else.
It's the ink.
Hey.
What the hell is spirulina? Sorry, I'm uneducated.
That's a very good question, actually.
What is spirulina?
No, everyone's saying, oh, it's a spirulina.
No, it's the spirulina that makes it blue.
What is that?
Yeah, but what is it? That's exactly.
I'm just saying the name.
It's a biomass of. Oh, God.
It's a blue-green algae and is believed to be one of the oldest life forms on Earth. First used by the Aztecs as an endurance booster, spirulina is considered a superfood, an all-in-one source of nutrients, including protein levels comparable to eggs.
Oh my God. Brilliant.
So basically, it's the oldest form of food, which means it's probably gone stale, and that's why it
That's fine by me.
Nice.
I'm happy with that.
So we're eating like prehistoric bacteria. Yeah. Nice. It's pretty cool stuff, though. Look at it.
It's gorgeous.
Pure blue spirulina powder.
That's
26 quid for 75 grams.
What?
What? It's 360 quid per kilo.
Oh my God.
Oh dear.
I'm looking at it now. That's mad. Spirulina.
I don't care. I like it.
Sounds like a song.
I think it's the best choice for a drink.
Well, it sounds like a name of a song by an 80s rock band, doesn't it?
That might be why I like it.
Yeah.
Power ballad.
Power ballad. Spirulina.
Don't start. All right. Don't start.
Spirulina.
I did something wrong in a previous life. I'm pretty convinced of it. Love it.
I'm
cool. Okay, well, we'll stay with you then, Carey, and you can bring bring our pizza topping.
But I want to be with Spirulina.
But you know, Joey's going to hate me because it's going to be ham and pineapple.
Oh.
But if you won't let me have ham and pineapple, because I know it's not a proper pizza topping, I'll have spicy chicken and peppers and onion.
Oh, that's strong.
If that's acceptable.
That is perfectly acceptable.
That's quite a strong choice.
That is a very strong choice. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No fruits on pizzas. No pineapple.
Thank you.
But I'm going to have to try the blue beer sausage one. Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I want to try it. I'm not guaranteed I'm going to like it.
I'm going to have to try it.
Are you talking real sausage?
Oh, Tien, I'm sorry.
You can sprinkle some spirulina on it and it'll be just...
It's not the same. It's not the same.
Just for the blue pizza effect.
I'll make you eat it.
Well, because the blueberries are not enough. Okay.
Because you need extra vitamins.
Always need extra vitamins.
Innocent pizzas. Which you then blend into...
not so innocent pizzas.
Well, here's another food line. You could take a really nice pizza and then just blend it into a smoothie.
Oh, God, no. Why would you do that?
Jerry.
I don't know.
That would be disgusting.
Add some spirulina.
Shove some extra vitamins in there just because we need them.
And then you'd
have
to
do some... getting any younger.
You'd have to do some variation of Bolt from the Blue. It'd be like...
What, on the pizza?
Well, yeah, like a smoothie pizza would have to be something like a... I don't know.
Blended cheese does not sound good.
No. No, I'm not going there.
But you could do a whole line of foods like blended burgers, blended hot dogs.
Doesn't that remind you of that deconstructed people used to
do? Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a deconstructed cappuccino. I'm going to give you a little
bottle
of coffee.
And a thing of milk.
The only thing you wanted to give them
make
back
it yourself.
Middle finger.
Yeah, but that's what they do in IKEA. But that's what they do in IKEA, don't they? When you go,
deconstructed
when you go and eat
furniture.
There, everything's
they don't do deconstructed. The food deconstructed, though. You get the Swedish meatballs with like the sauce on it, right? They don't give you the meatballs and say, construct your food.
Make it yourself.
IKEA, do
they? They give you an instruction manual. You have to form the balls, make the sauce.
Careful what you're phrasing.
Yeah.
Careful.
My mother's listens to this.
Okay. What have you been doing? Ball handling at IKEA. Sorry. With my new girlfriend, Spirulina. She's lovely.
There's going to be someone who's called Spirulina. I
there is.
You.
And Naaved's going to get sued wrongly again. So it's three court cases. They'll mistake my voice for Naaved's voice and they'll be like, right, I'm suing him.
And he'll be back in court and he'll have to get his meal deal from Tesco's again, won't he?
Oh, no! Oh, God! No way!
It's a strong choice anyway, well, Kerry, I'll say that.
Thank you, love.
Yes.
It's not one that Jerry approves of for the first one, but I approve of it, so that's fine.
Pineapple, for
goodness. That's fine. All the more pizza for me.
Tien, do you want to give us your pizza topping of choice?
I don't generally eat pizza unless somebody's ordered
it. I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah.
Because I am lactose intolerant, very boring, very 21st century boring people. So I don't really eat cheese. So I like to play, my husband calls it like dairy roulette when it comes to pizza. So, you know, we'll try it. Let's have a go. Is it going to make you sick today? Quite possibly. But if I was to have a pizza, it's probably going to be kind of a vegetarian thing with no cheese on it. And that with like essentially an antipasti board on top. So, you know, artichokes and peppers and all of that shit.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Very boring.
Actually, that sounds quite good.
It's fine.
Yeah,
because you've got a nice pizza dough bread. And you put the artichokes in. They'll be resting in oil.
Oh, that'd be lovely.
Some chili flakes on top. I could. That and a glass of wine.
Sounds good.
Got me covered.
Cheers.
Tien, I'm coming.
Cheers.
Down.
Your pizza's not the dirty stop out pizza that you'd get like after like six pints at the World's End.
It's gonna be like a sourdough crust.
Yeah.
Thin sourdough crust with, you know, Italian antipasti on top.
Why?
Yeah, you're the type
sounds
of one
good.
You posh restaurant, nice glass of red wine, all that types of stuff. That's the one.
It's can, not someone to me,
can someone explain to me the yes. anti bit? What why anti?
Why do you ask the question? You've been listening to Catherine. You've been listening to Catherine too much at work, Jerry, because she's
so?
The one that asks all
ask
the questions like this.
Right, okay.
Jesus.
As in why antipasto?
Why is it antipasto?
Why anti?
Antipasto. I think that means it comes from, I think, doesn't anti mean before?
Oh, maybe. Yeah, I think you might be right.
I think it does. I'm not sure, though.
Yeah, I think you're... Someone
is. Think who's got the Google?
That would be my dinner. Arriving.
Yum. What have you got?
Because I'm here, nobody can be bothered to cook, so curry is being delivered.
Ooh.
Yeah, but have you eaten?
Ooh. And we're all really tired. So,
Tien, have you eaten? Delivered. Or are you going to have curry now? You're going to eat on the podcast. Excellent.
I'm going to eat afterwards.
Oh dear. Yes, it means before.
Oh wow. Naaved.
Like an antechamber.
Back of the net.
There we go.
Nice.
I'm trying to forget Latin.
I don't remember you doing Latin. I don't remember you doing Latin.
Yeah, I don't remember before. You doing Latin.
No, I didn't want to. Did what was his name? Yeah, big putty bastard.
Can't help you,
Mr. Wood.
Wood.
He ran Wood. a bit of Latin
on the side.
Well,
he did side hustle of Latin.
He did side hustle in Latin, and I tried it for, or I had to do it because I was told I had to do it for about a term.
Really?
And, didn't like it at all. When we were about 13, me and you properly started hanging out.
Yeah, I know, but I don't remember our school covering Latin at all.
Can I just say,
see, I did Latin.
You just say, before you and Jerry started hanging out, so you were a super nerd, and then you met Jerry.
No,
and
what happened?
Then it all went downhill.
Actually, and the only reason I took Latin because my dad made me do it.
Oh, really?
Otherwise, oh, bless him.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I tried it. But no, I was never the nerd because, well, the results showed that I was never.
Yeah, I think that'd probably be the last word I would have used to describe Naaved. Definitely not nerd. He's an anti-nerd.
Especially after I fucked everything up.
Yeah,
anti-nerd, as in before nerd.
The before nerd.
Yeah, before nerd. He's not quite got there yet.
Now I'm the nerd.
It's a lot.
Yeah, yeah, now you're the nerd.
You are the nerd now because you knew antipasto.
Yeah.
So you've now reached that
exactly.
point, so you're officially the nerd. Up to this point, you were just an anti-nerd.
Anti-nerd.
Oh, dear. I've still not yet figured out which one of the five of you was going to be the nerd.
Now so, you know.
Yeah. Now I know.
It's not Tien with all the books and
it's
stuff in
not.
The background. Don't let that fool you. There's 500 books behind her that's got nothing to do with it.
They're all fake.
Okay, cool.
All right, fair enough.
It's all fake news. Is that what it is? This is fake news.
Is it wallpaper? Does it make it look like a bookshelf?
But you know what happened during COVID, right? Sales of secondhand books rocketed. Absolutely rocketed. You know why? It's because people are on calls like this with their office. They wanted to look intelligent. So they all, loads of people went and bought secondhand books.
Seriously?
They never read. Stuck them behind them to look better.
No way.
Because until then, they'd never done the video conferencing as much as they did from home, right? So...
True.
When we built this, I had to cull my books. This is about probably 50% because they didn't fit.
I can't fit all mine on the bookshelf either.
Some of my books are on someone's shelf who's pretending that they've read them.
Really? Some of mine are on the floor.
I had to give them to the charity shop, and so.
No way.
I went through Is it Marie Kondo? I went through that phase where I went, "Do you love it? Do you feel joy?"
Yeah.
No, Marie Kondo, I haven't read it again, so I might have to go and buy them back.
I sold all of mine, and then I've got Kindle.
You had an attic full of books, didn't you, Naaved? You said you had had an attic full.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did.
Can't do Kindle.
I did, and then what happened was, when the kids came, I don't know where they came from, Walton's fucking house, and next thing you know, I'm buying every damn.
Did you just say you don't know where your kids came
from? Where the kids came from?
One day, I woke up, they were just there.
Just there? I don't know what happened.
You had a bookshelf space to take out the air. Right,
so I like the sound effect of them. Sorry.
These girls just arrived. All my books got off. That was it. Job done.
I thought we educated you in that when you were younger.
What?
I don't know what this conversation is now going on. Right?
Was it you who bought me the joy set?
Hmm. Was that not helpful?
Well, clearly not.
No. Obviously not. Yeah, I know the pictures were black and white. I'm sorry.
It's like an IKEA manual.
We've lost Tom.
Insert here.
Yeah, it's like an IKEA manual.
Got to put it together yourself.
That's my one.
From the ground up. Oh, dear. I suppose in that one, you also potentially have to roll some balls, but well, that's probably a conversation.
Probably.
And it involves wood. Sorry.
Thanks, Joe.
You're welcome.
Probably, yeah.
My mother's going to be very disappointed.
She will be, she will be. She might have to skip this episode, I think.
This is definitely the Distinct and Jovial podcast after dark. Oh dear, right. Naaved, did you say your pizza? I've lost track. I'm supposed to be keeping on track.
No, we haven't done Naaved's pizza.
Yeah, but mine's really quite simple. I mean, there's nothing radical about it. I was thinking of saying I'll try something different, like how about wasps? Because that would be awesome. No one's ever pizza with wasps. But I reckon, you know, might just tickle your throat on the way down. So I went kind of regular, and I'm going for mushrooms, ham, olives, chili flakes, and a drizzle of chili oil.
And then,
voila. It's got to be thin crust. It can't be enough. You've got to eat it with a knife and fork. Any dick that says you've got to eat it with your hands is wrong.
Okay. Really?
It's got to be in the knife and fork. You, in Italy, they eat it with a knife and fork. Only the Yanks, the cook, have everything to do with like that. That's just wrong.
Don't even need to mention Room 101. I've already started.
Yeah, that's
we'll get to that.
That's an anti-Room 101.
It has to be eaten with a knife and fork. That is amazing. That's probably the best thing I've had. Fair enough. Bit complex for me, but I'm a bit more of a simple man. And apologies, I've got very distracted because I've just realised how much of a carrot I look like with the green screen. That's suddenly popped into my head the last few times. When we started talking about black and white earlier, my mind just completely went to that. And I was like, I don't know whether to point it out, but I think I am going to point it out. For the audio listeners of this podcast, you need to go look at the YouTube video to understand the colour of my the hoodie that I'm currently wearing.
Yeah, I couldn't really figure out if that was orange or not.
Okay, should we go on to room 101? Who would like to have their rant first?
In the bed, I'm stepping back.
He's not going to put his phone.
We might not get to anything else.
No, you will, you will. My ultimate choice in room 101 would be me, accompanied by Zoe Saldana, Olga Kurlanger, and some
Fair enough.
And if I was going to be in room 101 for a really long time, some Viagra too. For now, we'll just go with the deodorant. I'm assuming I can't do things like, you know, war or religion or God.
We'd all put in there, yeah.
So I've got a list, unfortunately. I can't choose one thing. So I went with mosquitoes because they kill more people than anybody else in any given year. Cyclists who run red lights because I want to shoot them in the back of the head when they do it. If I see them doing it, I just want to go crazy. The only thing stopping me is that I can't carry a gun legally here. Otherwise, there'd just be blood over the pavement. I'd go with reality TV.
Yeah.
Influencers.
You say influencers until Dom and Jerry become influencers, and then we're going to love them.
Well, we'll never refer to myself as an influencer. I don't want to influence anything other than influence anything that I do. No, don't do it.
I think I could say that if Jerry and Dom became influencers, I would support them because they've made me laugh here. But I've never seen another influencer that has ever made me laugh. They all look like dicks, and they mostly act like dicks. And then Americanisms in English.
Whether
state spelling, or the way they talk, and they say like, and you know, and all of that. Makes me want to shoot them in the face. And then I think one of the others I really don't like, I'd like to take like a proper Percy Pig made in bacon and shove it up their backsides of militant vegans.
What?
You know the ones that really just preach on about the vegans and how they're saving the planet, yeah, not realising that avocado flew halfway across the bloody planet. Those guys, they need bacon inserted up their backsides. That's it.
Okay.
Quite a short list for you, Naaved.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Very restrained.
We need more storage space in room 101. Need to go to IKEA.
Just borrow Tien's bookcase.
Yeah.
So, I can expand on any one of them.
Anything else?
I don't think there's any that I disagree with. That's the difference. The cyclist running red lights, that was a real trigger, I think. I could see everybody go, yes, I get that one.
Well, I tell you, if I was in front of the queue, when I see them do that, what I feel like doing is saying, I'm going to jump the red light too. And let's see whether I can mow you down before you come to the next red light. Yeah? That's what I want to do. If I miss, if I'm coming close, I'll just say to my daughter, open a car door. And
so we've got the National Cycling Association to add to the list of court cases.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's going to be a lot of meal deals.
You've probably got
PETA
too.
PETA.
Yeah, a lot of probably, meal yeah, deals. Yeah.
Vegans, PETA. Vegan runners, vegan everyone.
I saw a film once when someone said, hey, I'm from PETA, and someone said, oh, I thought that meant people eating tasty animals. Hilarious. That's one of the funniest things ever.
Oh, brilliant.
That's terrible.
Done. That's brilliant. Oh dear. Let's go to Carey. What would you like to put in room 101?
I've been quite restrained in terms of Naaved.
You want to put me in room 101?
No, I wouldn't put you in there. No, that's not what I'm saying.
With Zoe Saldana?
Not yet. Yeah, well, yeah, if you want to go in with some other people, that's fine. I'll stick you in if you'd like to go. But I live out in the middle of nowhere, out in the sticks. Jerry's been to my house, so he knows this is true. There are little narrow country lanes. They're big enough for some, like, 1.5 cars, and I want to put inconsiderate bloody drivers who don't turn off their main beam, take up the entire road, don't move out of the way, and push you into the ditch in room 101, because they piss me off.
That's a strong choice.
Do you know what? I can help with that.
Can you?
You just give me a sniper rifle and a perch on your roof, I can take out those headlights every single time.
I actually want to take out those people.
It's just getting really dark. Literally.
I just want the car. Just get rid of the car.
Metaphorically and literally.
Yeah. Exactly.
Is that it?
And I stuck to one. Yeah, I stuck to one.
Oh, wow. Okay. That's a strong one.
That's the one that really grinds your gears.
Really grinds your gears. Yeah.
Well done. I found that so hard. Well done. That you could do that.
What, that I could be restrained. Thanks.
Mine is longer.
I'm guessing that already.
No, it's just.
Do I get a medal?
It is that, because that's really bad. It's when people don't realise and you flash and then they still don't switch their full beams off and you think.
Okay. That's because I don't care. My dick, that's why I swing in the wind when I flash.
I didn't realise you were behind me at all times.
Hence the beam is on.
Oh.
No trouble finding it. So you look down and go, oh, no, let's put the beams on, map, closer look.
Fair enough, yeah.
Yeah.
That's fine. Could you stop doing that?
Yeah. Sorry.
It's really distracting. Do you?
No comment.
I'm afraid to say that I have a very modern car with LED headlights, so nobody does it to me because I just then flick mine on and you just burn the retinas of everybody 3 miles
nice.
Away.
Nice.
Well, so
fun.
Do I. But I'm nice.
I do too many miles to be nice. I did 15,000 miles in the last 12 months. Like, I haven't got patience for
15,000? Oh, yeah, I suppose. Yeah, 15, of course.
000. I have my lovely... Well, February's been a very lackluster month. In fact, I did 0 miles in February. Between
what,
February and 18th.
Really?
It was hard to drive.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. I've drove the car for the first time in 4 weeks on Sunday.
How was that?
So, yeah, it was fine.
How was it?
Yeah, it was fine. I thought it was going to be horrible, but it was it was horrible in the fact that I was driving up the M5. But that's
horrible.
That's just kind of pretty standard whenever you're on the M5. That it's pretty horrible. And similar to you, it's like, which Muppet have we got on the road today? Which one is sat in the middle lane? Which one is sat doing 60 miles an hour? Which lorry is overtaking the other lorry? Oh, you name it.
Yeah.
Okay, Tien, what would you like to put in room 101?
So I also had cyclists for various reasons. Cyclists who run red lights, but also because I used to cycle to work and ride my Brompton very sedately. And in London, I guess everywhere, but in London we have lots of like cycle lanes that have their own special red light. So you can go before all the cars. And what I really hate are the kind of cyclists, let's call them men in Lycra, who decide that when you're waiting there, they have to, even though they came up behind, you know, were behind you, they have to come in front of you and like squeeze through all the people during rush hour to get to the front so that they can go first. They really, really irritate me because they're arrogant. And then you normally catch up with them later because they're not that good at cycling. but also I do have two things as well. So between Carey and Naaved, my husband said I was a bit wrong for this. I really dislike couples who don't know how to walk properly on a pavement. when I'm walking by myself and I'm walking towards a couple and they will not move out of the way. And I'm expected to step onto the road so they can continue to hold hands. They really irritate me. So sometimes I don't move to make them part ways because I shouldn't have to get run over so that they can continue their love. There you go.
Nice.
You know what? I like that.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
We can go with
strong.
That.
You've got a strategy for you as well, right? You see them approaching.
Sniper rifle?
Well, yeah, obviously.
I was going to go for something that won't get you arrested, but what I was going to suggest is, you know...
Naaved is an expert in not going to court.
Yeah.
As you see them walking towards you hand in hand and they won't move out of the way, then what you want to do is you want to just all of a sudden just have a little little flick and fit, like go as you're walking towards you. Guarantee you those fuckers will hit the pavement. They won't even part and just go up. Guaranteed.
Or,
I've done it.
Or just throw up.
Hey, yeah.
Just suddenly throw up.
Oh, just because all of us can do that on will.
Yeah,
Jerry.
On cue. Just throw up on cue. And they'll move. It'll be fine.
Or you could always carry a pamphlet with you. A Jehovah's Witness pamphlet. That's what you do. Rip her out, man.
I got one of them through my door today.
Did you? Did you really?
I'd like to point out, I live in a flat with a coded door.
Ooh.
So I said, I did ask them, how did you get through the coded door? And they went, it was already open. And I went, that's breaking and entering. I suggest you leave before I call the police.
No way.
Bye bye.
Well, I like the fact, so I'm in a flat at the moment, and I actually got something through the letterbox said, important information about your conservatory.
Excellent.
You couldn't make it up, could you?
Because I'm going to have to go under the Royal Mail.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
It did remind me of that, actually, Dom.
Exactly that. I'm going to expand on yours, Tien. I just think that anybody that walks slowly on the path or across the path, and the ones that drive me nuts is I live on fairly busy main road in Jovial, in Jovial, if you can call it a busy main road, and it's the school kids. They walk like six abreast across along the path, even though you can probably get four comfortably. They're all sat like this, like trying to text each other on their phones and stuff like that. And it's just like, dude, get out of the way. Fortunately, I'm 6'3", so when I come and walk through, they normally go, oh, hang on a minute, I best move out the way.
I'm going to go this way.
Yes. It's nice to be large and intimidating.
Nice.
Okay, I'm going to move the topical event to be a little bit later because it might depend a little bit on the time that we have because it's. I don't want to keep you too long for this one because I'm not sure that my cheeks can cope with it with the laughter that we've had so far. So I need to give myself a little bit of a rest. I'm going to come to the blindly rate this section, which I think can be a little bit interesting, but. I actually have a choice for you because I had a backup because I saw there was some. Oh, I haven't had cocktails in a while, so we can do the blindly rate cocktails. Or I also have ready a blindly rate drunk foods. Which would you prefer?
Well, I know which one Carey would go for. Well, and? Because you have to, don't you?
Well, I can't have cocktails
can't have
anymore,
cocktails,
can I?
So.
Oh.
No, not for the past 30-odd years.
There's a story in that, but it doesn't sound like a podcast where there's a story on that one.
No, I'm fatally allergic to alcohol if I ingest it.
Wow, okay. that definitely takes the... I thought I had it bad with caffeine.
No, self-inflicted.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Well, so same here. There's too many caffeinated
too many.
Drinks at university to try and keep you awake.
Too much scotch. I blame Naaved. I can if I want to.
She's still trying to stick me to room 101, guys. Somebody, come on, spin me.
I was putting you in there with people you want to go in with.
No, so the behind that is that Carey and myself used to catch the same bus to from school. And we
so did Tien.
I got that bus. I'm not fatally allergic to alcohol. Yeah.
You didn't end up in the Bates house.
Used to get on it before.
Yeah.
So she had the longer journey. But we used to live around the corner from each other. And occasionally after school, when we wanted to just talk shy or gossip or whatever, Tien would come round to my house because her parents didn't like brown people at all.
So, not Tien.
Carey.
No, Carey.
Am I Tien?
sorry, Carey. Carey. Carey used to come around my house and we'd sit there and start talking. And then probably around about half an hour afterwards, I'd say, do you want a drink? And then she'd say, yeah. And then what we'd do, we'd just open my dad's drinks cabinet, get a bottle of scotch, two glasses, and sit there for another 2 hours.
Yeah, usually, yeah.
And then his little bottle went down and down. Sorry. And he didn't seem to mind, so that was...
No, he was fine with it.
It was always quite fine.
I don't know how you got away with that.
So there you go. Yeah.
Your dad did that quite often. Your dad is cool.
He was. So
that was that, and then Tien was my teenage crush at school.
It's all coming out now.
We weren't going to talk about this.
It's all coming out. We weren't going to talk about
this. That's it now.
Study Green Disco, we're going to leave it there.
Now everyone's going to know. Tien, are you blushing?
On my topic again?
No.
Okay.
No. But she is now.
We agreed, everyone, what happens at Studley
Green
Disco.
We did. Studley Green Disco. Studley Green Disco.
The thing is, nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
There you go.
We've lost Dom. He's gone.
He has as well. He's frozen.
He has. You know he's gone.
Do you know what? That's a first. That is a first. That is actually usually my
fault.
We've
lost Dom.
We've actually lost Dom. No way.
Oh, my goodness.
No way. What should we talk about?
I'm going to crack my jokes then.
When you reveal all the big secrets.
Yeah, this is what happens.
Everything falls apart.
Yeah. Right, here we go. The fact that some people can't distinguish between etymology and entomology bugs me in ways I can't put into words.
Oh my god,
that's really good.
That, I like. Come that. On, that is good.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Here's another one. A colon. I don't even know if this. I think this is actually being recorded. So I don't know what Dom's going to do with this section.
It is being recorded.
It is. Yeah. A colon can completely change the meaning of a sentence. For example, Jane ate her friend's sandwich. Jane ate her friend's colon.
Oh,
sorry.
You've been dying to do that.
I have, actually. Sorry, Dom. I don't know what happened there. That's also a first. We lost you.
Yep.
What happened? Internet dropout.
I got a blue screen of death. My computer, old computer just went...
Seriously?
And I have a 2.5 grand computer and it just went... Bing. So...
Whoa, dude.
I don't know what just happened there.
Dude.
Yeah.
So, I just cracked two dad jokes, which I think have been recorded. So you might
decide whether you want to keep
it. If it's still recording for all of you or not, then it should be fine. I just don't know the timestamps that we're at now because it's reset for me. So
we're at 1 hour and 2 minutes and 23, 24, 25.
No, you're right. Stop.
No problem is it killed all my windows that I had open, so I'm trying to open up all my windows in the background. And stuff.
Shall I do one more dad joke then?
You can do one more dad joke if you want.
Okay. I went to the zoo yesterday and saw a slice of toast in a cage. When I asked the keeper why, he said it was bred in captivity.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my goodness.
I started a band called Blanket. It's a cover band. It's illegal to laugh out loud in Hawaii. Did you know that? It's illegal to laugh out loud in Hawaii. You have to keep it to a low ha.
Oh, all right, you can stop now. You can stop now. That's stop. Enough.
I mean, if these are the dads,
get it under control.
I've only got one more to go. Do you know if you sneeze and fart at the same time, your body takes a screenshot?
I like that one.
Thank you.
Somebody had to.
It didn't have to, but I'm chuffed. Right. Oh, it's my dad joke's done. I did my research.
Was that for your topical events?
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Yeah.
We should have, perhaps you should have renamed that the try not to laugh section as try not to groan section,
or,
I suppose.
Or try to laugh.
Yeah.
Just try to laugh.
Yeah, it's fine. I would say, do you not want to carry on with your jokes while I try and just make sure that the PC is so I don't die again?
Yeah, go for it. Come on, somebody else must have some dad jokes.
I have, but they're not very good because I hate dad jokes.
Oh, because of course my jokes are just so great.
Yeah, they're fantastic.
Yeah.
So, never date a tennis player. Love means nothing to them.
Whacked.
Oh, God. Joe's going to use that one.
I like that one. I like that.
Two guys walk into a bar. The third one ducks.
Oh dear.
So, Jen, you're very sensible.
I was thinking about ducks and duck wrapping and 50 Cent.
Oh, here we go.
I was thinking we've gone back to Donald again now.
In a blanket, yeah.
And 50 Cent.
Do you have any
Someone
others?
Else must have some. I have, but okay. I'm not going to do them all.
A mummy covered in chocolate and hazelnuts has been discovered in Egypt. Archaeologists believe it may be Pharaoh Rochet.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That is bad.
That is awful. I love That's it, but bad. That is terrible.
I asked my wife if the cup was half full or half empty. And she said, for the last fucking time, stop wearing my bras.
Oh.
Come on, no.
That was funny.
That was amazing.
Tien, have you got any?
Come on, Tien.
Come on, Tien.
I don't really do joke. I'm not a funny person. So I had to Google. I had to Google search some jokes. But I only have one. It's what is Forrest Gump's computer password? One, Forrest, one.
Oh my
That's
God.
It.
Lord.
But also because my son's favourite film is Forrest Gump. No!
Oh no! God. That's gonna have to be cut.
You've got a minute, it's funny though.
Right, timestamp. Timestamp. 1 minute.
What's the timestamp?
1 hour, 6 minutes.
Well, to me, it's 5 minutes, 47 seconds, yeah. So I don't, because it all crashed.
1 hour, 6 minutes.
Do you remember what one of your favourite jokes used to be at school? It was a horse walks into a bar and the barman says, "Why the long face?"
Yeah. Yeah, I remember
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. Remember yeah. That. Yeah.
Oh, there's a
well
yeah, go on. No, go on.
I was to say I can finish this off with the three that I've got. So how does NASA organize a party? They plan it.
I just love that joke.
Milk is the fastest liquid in the world. It's pasteurized before you can even see it.
Oh, very good. Very good.
And as I suspected, someone has been adding soil to my garden. The plot thickens.
Oh, very good. Brilliant.
Well, I think what we'll do is we'll do a blindly rate then of drunk foods. And I say drunk foods, they're more like junk foods than drunk foods as well. But these are probably what you would have got on a nice night out. Jerry after his 12th beer at the World's End.
12th, normally. Yeah.
12?
I wouldn't have made it to even the 6th.
God.
So in case I'll read out one. You've got to put it in where you would out of 1 to 5, but you don't know what the next ones are going to be. So it just kind of like a, do I play it safe or do I just go sod it? I love that one. I'll put it at 1, or I absolutely detest that one. I'll put that at 5.
And we're not doing this as a collective. We're doing this individually, right? So
you can do it individually. Individually,
we never manage as a collective.
Yeah, that's true.
For the consensus, we're not.
Yeah, that's true.
No.
Each person for their own.
Okay.
It's person for their own. Oh dear. Cool. Okay, so the first one I've got is a crisp sandwich.
Crap, bollocks. Number 5, right at the bottom.
I'm going to go with 4.
I'm going 4. There's got to be something worse than a crisp sandwich.
Am I getting involved as well, Dom?
Yeah, get on with it, Jerry.
Are you doing it as well? You've got to do it then as well.
No. I've got the list in front of me because right. I can see the list. There's no point me
doing
it.
Yeah, that's true.
I know what's coming up.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, I think I'm with Naaved. I'd go 5 on that.
Ooh, okie dokie. And if I pressed the right shortcut, that would have helped. So we've got curry sauce and chips.
5.
I think I throw a 5 from Carey on that one.
Mm-hmm. I'm at 4.
5 is the worst, yeah. Going to go 3.
I like your strategy. So you're leaving that little gap there so you can fit on the 1, the 4 and the 5. Yeah.
I might regret this. What?
But curry sauce.
No. So you're talking about chips smothered in curry sauce?
Yeah, chips and curry sauce.
I might regret this. I'm going to go for 3.
Oh, so Jerry's done a 3 and a 5. Tien's a 4 and a 3. Both Carey and Naaved have used their 4 and 5s up. So you've better got to hope that these next ones are good for you. So the next one is... a kebab.
3.
It's got to be 1 or 2. Just in case, I'm going for a 2 on this one.
Can I ask what type of kebab it is?
Ooh, make your pick.
Well, no, because if it's the one where they shave the meat off the
thing,
John,
the elephant leg. Elephant leg.
Then it's 5. If it's like, you know, chicken on a skewer... then with like some salad, then I go a 2.
I'll take as it's your choice. I'll take a 2 because
okay,
your 5's already taken. Jerry,
I'm going 2.
You've got 1, 2, and 4 left.
Yeah, I'm going for 2.
2. Okie dokie. Number 4, Burger King.
What?
A Burger King, specifically Burger King. 1.
Easy. Yeah, it's got to be.
Really?
Anything I want from Burger King. I mean,
really?
Anything, right?
Yeah. 1.
Serious?
Yeah. 1.
Over a kebab.
Burger King are disgusting.
God, yeah.
What the hell?
Because it's stodge and it's greasy stodge. And
that's what you need when you're drunk.
You need it. 9 times out of 10, it's...
it's good.
You go inside... as well, you don't have to stand outside if it's pissing their
it's
own.
True.
And
yep.
It's warm. You've got toilets, you can wash your hands.
Yep. Hang about, we're just getting some facilities and... No, wait. No, we're just...
We need facilities.
You can't use...
When you're drunk.
When you're drunk, if this is drunk eating, by the time you're drunk and ordering a Burger King, the facilities are shut.
Well, yeah, that's a good point.
Right?
I can tell you. Depends on the Burger King.
I'll tell you stag do story from Burger King in a minute because the facilities brings it up. But sorry, Tien and Jerry, you've got Jerry. You've
four.
Got a choice of one or four.
Yeah, four.
And Tien, you've got a choice of. Well, I've got to work this out now.
One or five, I think.
One or five.
I'm regretting my strategy now. I'm going to go five.
Okay, so by default, so for Tien, your number one is, number one for Tien, this is three, number two for Carey.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Number two for me.
No, you did kebab number two.
Oh yeah, you're right, number three.
So this is your number three.
Yeah.
And Jerry, this is your
number one.
Two, three, five. This is your number one. And you'll be either glad or horrified to know that it's pizza.
Oh, yay. So
I can live with that. I can live with that.
If you have artisan pizza, sourdough pizza with some antipasti on the top, then I'm okay.
No, it's a drunk pizza from a really bad pizza place on the way home from clubbing.
That's terrible. It's going to be really thick, probably with some cheese in the crust. Ugh.
It's going to have loads of meat on it.
Nice.
See, Jerry's quite happy with that.
I'm actually quite pleased with that, because the thing is, I was holding out the number one spot for curry. I thought you were going to get curry in there, but you didn't.
No.
But pizza's okay. I'm happy with that. Pizza number one. I've eaten pizza drunk enough times, so...
I think that's the first time you've been happy with one of these with one of these blind rates. There's been the last few that I've done with the movie franchises and the chocolate snacks. You were pretty in agony over a couple of them when I made you put The Mummy second.
Yeah. Oh no!
What the hell? Yeah. But I'm pleased with that.
Absolute gem set of a film with Brandon Fraser. Cannot beat The Mummy.
Yeah. It's where he got all his injuries from, isn't it? Because he put. He then put on loads of weight, didn't he?
He has.
Yeah.
Did he win an Oscar?
He did win it. Yeah, he did for The Whale. And it was a very personal storyline for him as well. And apparently an amazing performance. I haven't seen it yet.
No, nor have I.
Me neither.
I'm curious, how many Oscar winning films do you reckon you've actually seen?
God, loads.
Tons. Oscar-winning films?
Loads. Yes.
Yeah.
Loads.
Couldn't tell you. Gone with the Wind. Yeah. Loads. Tons.
Yeah.
Loads. Absolutely loads.
Probably about 100, I'd say. Because if you can get Oscar... you can get, yeah, but yeah, probably more. Because you get Oscars for best score, best script, best music.
Okay.
Best wardrobe.
Best wardrobe.
Change that for like... film Oscar, films have you
watched? Yeah, I was going to say
best
the top
film Oscars.
Oh, film Oscars.
I'd need a list.
I'd need a list to know, actually.
Yeah,
I'd need a list to know. Yeah, definitely.
Still be a lot.
I mean, I've seen some great winners of the annual porn awards.
Amazing. Have you?
Yeah, excellent. Yeah. I have to say.
I didn't have to do that when we were in Denmark. It just came on the telly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember you saying about that.
Yeah, I do.
So is it the Academy Award for Best Picture? Is the one that you want?
Oh, Best Picture.
Yeah. So it's like, but we need a list going back through our entire lives. You could be ill wild on. and back to the 50s, I mean, because we have watched some old films.
I was going to say, this has gone down. This goes down to 1938.
Let's go.
All right. Let's go.
You Can't Take It With You.
Nope.
Wings.
Nope.
Is that Red Bull?
Yeah, Red Bull, yeah.
It's a film about KFC.
West Side Story.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Tom Jones.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Rebecca.
Yep.
I dated her.
On the Waterfront.
Yeah.
Yes.
No.
My Fair Lady.
Yeah.
Mutiny on the Bounty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mrs. Minerva.
Mrs. Minerva, yeah.
Yeah, Minerva. Marty. The Lost Weekend.
No.
Life of Emile Zola.
No.
Yes.
Lawrence of Arabia.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
It Happened One Night.
No.
Yeah.
That's How Green Was My Valley.
No. How?
No.
How Great Was My Valley? That How sounds green. Like something Naaved would read.
I don't think they had the Avian Awards back then.
They probably do have that one somewhere.
Hamlet.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Greatest yeah. Show on Earth.
Yeah.
The Great Ziegfeld.
No.
No.
Grand Hotel.
No.
Yes.
Gone with the Wind.
Yeah.
Yes.
Going My Way.
No.
No.
Gigi.
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
Gentleman's Agreement.
No.
No.
From Here to Eternity.
Yeah. What?
Yes.
Casablanca.
Yeah.
That's the first one yeah. I've actually seen. The Broadway Melody.
No.
No.
The Bridge on the River Kwai.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Best Years of Our Lives.
No.
Lives.
No.
Ben Hur.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Around the World in 80 Days.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then they come in thick and fast. The Apartment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
An American in Paris.
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
All the King's Men.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All Quiet on the Western Front.
Yeah.
All About Eve.
Yes.
The Sound of Music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A Man for All Seasons.
No.
No.
In the Heat of the Night.
Yeah.
No.
No.
Oliver.
Yes.
Midnight Cowboy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Patton.
Yeah.
The French Connection. I found the second one I've seen. The Godfather.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Sting. The Godfather Part 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Yeah.
So we're now into the 1970s. Rocky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Annie Hall.
Yeah.
No.
The Deer Hunter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kramer versus Kramer.
Yeah.
No.
Ordinary People.
No.
No.
Chariots of Fire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Gandhi.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Terms of Endearment.
No.
Yeah.
Amadeus.
Yeah. Amadeus.
Amadeus.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
Amadeus.
Such a good film.
Yeah.
Such a good film. Yeah.
Out of Africa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Platoon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Last Emperor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Rain Man.
Yeah.
Yes.
Driving Miss Daisy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dances with Wolves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I've seen this one and it's a great year, 91. The Silence of the Lambs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unforgiven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Schindler's List.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Braveheart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The English
Patient.
Patient.
Yeah.
Patient, yeah.
Yeah. Titanic, which I've still not seen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, it sinks. Shakespeare.
Spoiler alert.
Damn it.
So he's being selfish, doesn't let him on the little bit of wood. He dies.
He dies. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Tien.
You've ruined it for Dom.
It was bad enough that I didn't know it sank.
Shakespeare in Love.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
American Beauty.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
The single greatest film known to man, Gladiator.
Yeah.
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 A Beautiful Mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chicago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lord of the Rings, Return of the King.
Yep.
Yeah.
Million Dollar Baby.
Yeah.
No.
Crash.
No.
No.
The Departed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No Country for Old Men.
Yeah.
No.
Slumdog Millionaire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hurt Locker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
King's Speech.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Artist.
No.
No.
Argo.
Yeah.
Yes.
12 Years a Slave.
Yeah.
No.
Last 10 Years, then we've got Birdman.
No.
No.
Spotlight.
No.
No. No.
Moonlight.
No.
No.
Shape of Water.
Yes.
No.
No.
Green Book.
No. No.
Parasite.
No.
No.
Nomadland.
No.
No.
Coda.
No.
No.
Everything, Everywhere, All at Once.
No.
Yes. Yes.
And the 2023 winner was Oppenheimer.
No.
Not seen it yet.
I think I've realised I stopped watching films when my child was born.
Oh, you may have done.
It's a timeline.
It's like,
timeline.
Oh my God, I haven't watched anything for 15 years.
I got 65, Dom.
You counted?
65, wow.
65, yeah, of course I did.
Oh my God,
SWAT, remember?
That's true.
So now we know who the nerd of the group is, yeah?
SWAT, not nerd.
I can claim myself to be the self-professed nerd, and I'm happy to be able to take that title, so I'm always good.
You're welcome to it.
I have a bonus, which I haven't written on the thing. I've got a bonus blindly, but it's not a blindly rates. It's a blindly come up with something, but I'm going to explain the scenario. If you could see any stat from your when you die at the end, if you could see any stat of your life from when you die, and that could be number of beers drunk, that could be number of murderers walked past, number of friends that I encountered. But if you had one stat that you really would want to see, what would you have? Just putting you all on the spot.
It is. Can I go with hours spent with friends?
Oh, that's a good one.
That's a good one.
Aww, too.
See, now everything we say is going to sound really like...
It's going to sound really better than that, isn't it?
That was my plan.
So Jen's going, how many times I...
Tien, you don't have to go next.
I thought about my friends.
Pants up off the floor after asking for them to be put in the laundry basket.
I don't want to know that. Yeah. I'm with you on that. Mine doesn't use the laundry
basket.
But
would you really want to know that stat? Of
all
the stats?
See, I don't want to know that stat.
No. But I bet it's
I don't think you would want to know that.
Boring stat.
Waste of time.
How many kilometres have I run in my entire life? I don't know. Being a runner.
Oh, you know, now that's a good one.
That's quite a really good one.
Okay. Run as, without crying, maybe. That'd be quite
big. That'd be significantly smaller.
Run without complaining. Even smaller.
Even smaller.
Based on what me when I run, that would be zero because I'm always complaining when I'm running. there's no in between.
We're getting into single figures now.
just zero.
Yeah.
Every mile I've run, I've complained. Jerry or Naaved?
I find it really hard. Every time, it's going to sound really philosophical, but I'd rather not look at the individual brushstrokes. I'd rather step back and look at the whole picture. An individual stat would point to, I don't know, possibly individual errors and mistakes. And actually, I think I'd like to look back at the picture as a whole. The way you can see a painting in a gallery, you'd never step up close to see the artist's individual strokes. You look back the whole thing. So I think I'd look at my life like that. But if I had to choose a stat, really, I think I'd like to know the number of people that I have genuinely made smile.
This is.
Jerry,
no pressure, Jerry. No.
Well.
Or the number of people I've pissed off, because actually it'd be very good to see which
you know, balance it.
Did I give more good in the world, or did I give more bad?
Yeah, I mean that'd be an interesting thing to know. Did I piss off more people than I made happy, or vice versa?
Well, it depends on how many members of Peta there is at the moment, isn't there, after this podcast goes out.
And Tesco's.
Oh, dear.
So mine's along the same lines. I was actually going to say the number of people that I've genuinely made laugh. Like, made genuinely laugh.
Exactly.
not laugh because they feel sorry for me, or laugh because it's like, oh good lord. I'm just gonna have to go with this. I think I'd like to know how many people's lives I've genuinely impacted in a positive way. Like I've actually had a positive impact on their lives. I'd love to know that stat.
Well, as we had in our company at one point, Jerry, we had the hashtag going around, be more Jerry.
Be more Jerry, yeah. Yeah, I remember that. I do remember that. And Dom, you can't get away with this. You're gonna have to.
Come on. I feel really bad because I was going to pick something that was quite mundane, but because it's topical with the operation that I had, I was going to be very curious on how many punches and kicks I have thrown as part of my taekwondo career.
That's a good one. That is a good one.
I wanted to just a purely numerical stat to go, that's why my hip was completely ruined after the operation. So, yeah.
That's a good one.
That was the way I went. But it wasn't a philosophical one. But what I love, and Jerry, I'm sure we've had this a few times on the podcast, is sometimes you think, oh, am I going to get a funny answer? Sometimes we get these philosophical answers, and it just shows, I think it shows the better side of people. Steve did it as well. Didn't he?
He did. Yeah, he did.
Cool. Right, poignant questions. These are now going to test the friendships, I think, here. So, poignant question number one, do you brush your teeth before or after breakfast?
After.
After. Although sometimes both. Typically after, sometimes both.
I don't eat breakfast, but before.
Yeah, fair enough. I don't eat breakfast either, so before. Are you joining in as well, Dom?
I'm with Naaved. I'm a before and after.
Ooh.
Surprised you got any teeth left. Not worn out.
That's, I actually normally have the opposite, but yes.
Okay.
No. And then my bonus question is, have you ever brushed your teeth in the shower?
No.
Yeah. No. You have? What?
No.
What the hell?
Why?
So busy.
It's not while the water's running, because that's just a colossal waste. But, you know, brush your teeth and you're going to have to shower, that thing, the brush and all the rest of it. It's a bit weird, though.
Tien's expression is classic.
Not while the water's running, but so not while the water's running.
Put the water on, otherwise it's just running. You don't run the tap when you're brushing your teeth, right?
Yeah, but you don't put toothpaste in your toothbrush and then go, I'm just going to go and step in the shower.
No, okay, but the thing is, right, I did it actually because I was not in a normal bathroom, right? So, you know, one of those campsites where you know what a campsite is, obviously, but you know, they have a central...
Shared communal
place
shower.
Where there's a shower and a thing and
communal.
And actually, if you step away to brush your teeth, you lose your place in the queue, right? So, for the showers, and you wanted to be first in the showers because if you were later on, you didn't even know what was inside there when it was awful, you know?
Okay.
And, you know, people did all sorts of shitting and puking and whatever else. And so, it's not very nice. So, you have to get in there first. So, you take your toothbrush in. And so you've only got a shower cubicle. And the weirdest thing is, it's not normal to do it when you're butt. So you stand there butt and your dangly bits are hitting between your thighs and it's just...
What the hell?
I don't know. I can't relate.
TMI.
Now you know.
Easy.
I'm not sure how vigorously you're brushing your teeth that you're brushing your thighs whilst you're brushing your teeth.
I can be quite aggressive with that toothbrush.
I don't need to know.
I'm just going to revert back to a previous comment where Tien said that she wasn't funny. I'm going to dispute that.
That's a classic line. I thought you were saying something like in the interest of like efficiency, so you're kind of like squatting and having a crap in the shower whilst brushing your teeth at the same time with the water then running.
Crap in the shower. Yeah. That's
what we do. Because like, most people say, you know, you go for a brush your teeth and shower and like your morning routine, but you could do all three at the same time. I don't know, just a thought.
Also, if you're at the campsite, could you not, like, have a shower and then brush your teeth afterwards so you don't lose your spot in the shower, but, you know, just go?
No, because I was on a time limit, right? I was on a time limit. I had to be at a specific location every single day in the morning. So I didn't have a choice. I had to be ready. It was like work. So
get up five minutes earlier.
Yeah, get up earlier.
Well, he's doing, it just wasn't possible, but you've got a point.
I'll save you, Naaved. I have brushed my teeth.
Oh, Dom!
With the water running.
And I'll explain it. It normally, and it's not just once. It's normally when I'm hungover, because the thing I want to do is I just want to, like, just be under a shower while I'm trying to recover from a hungover. And I was like, oh, might as well brush. And the first thing I want to do is remove the gunk from my teeth, so I brush my teeth in the shower while I'm hungover. It only happens when I'm hungover, which is rare, but yeah, I brush my teeth in the shower when I'm hungover. That's
just
my hangover cure.
Before the shower.
No, I just want to get into the shower because I feel like grab my tooth. Yeah, done. It's all fair. About.
Well, yeah, I mean, I guess.
Fair enough.
Okay. Next one. This is just an intriguing one. Do you wash your coats?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we waterproof them.
I'm sorry?
That comes with someone living up north.
What are you trying to say?
What the hell is we waterproofing? What you do?
We waterproof them. You can get special stuff, you wash them in, and it re-waterproofs your waterproof coats for you.
Oh, I was just going to say I send mine to the owners.
So you live in London, love.
Oh, I didn't know you could do such
things. I had no idea.
Yeah.
I thought that when your coats ran out of waterproof, that was the sign to buy a new one.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, you could use that too, I guess. Yeah.
Well, that's my excuse anyway. Oh, no. Oh, no.
I need a new coat.
You might need a new coat, darling.
Well, if it works for you, Tien, keep doing it.
Oh, it rained on my handbag and shoes. I need to get some more.
Your best high heels, Jared.
Oh, no, my Louboutins got wet. Oh, no. Oh, Jesus.
Those are my excuses.
Fair enough.
You stick to them.
You don't have to justify this, Tien.
Exactly.
It's fine.
We believe you.
Yeah.
You're on your side.
Have you, Dom?
Okay, me, yeah, yes, and actually, I'm with Carey. I have re-waterproofed stuff.
Oh, wow! Okay,
see?
I didn't know you could do this.
Yeah, so, but that's because I did a Three Peaks. So I did like a 10,000 ridiculous like hydrostatic head like coat, and after Three Peaks, where I might as well have just been in a swimming pool. It needed re-waterproofing. He thought, oh, just buy another one. But I was like the second year into work and the coat was already 120 quid. So I was like, I could just use the official stuff that they gave me for free with the coat to re-waterproof it.
No way.
Exactly.
Never heard of this. Okay.
Yes. I'd like to point out, I still have that coat as well and it's still waterproof and I still have the bottle of waterproofing.
Oh my God.
Liquid, I suppose it is.
I've got litre bottles of the waterproofing stuff. Special coat wash stuff and special coat waterproofing stuff. It smells like copper decks.
It does. Okay. It does. It really does.
What do you paint it on?
No, you stick it in the washing machine and then
wash it. Stick it in the washing machine.
Yeah, but is that not waterproof even the inside and the outside? Or does it just bond with the outside? I mean, how does the science work?
It sticks to the coat.
No, but the inside will be lined with something. It'll be different.
I don't care. As long as it's waterproof, I don't care.
Yeah, I suppose that's a good point. I'm serious.
What have you got lining your coat that you are that bothered about?
I don't know.
I was expecting a no comment.
No comment.
But wait.
Come on.
So, this is just a little bit weird. So you stick it in a washing machine with some kind of chemical that then
copy decks,
take it out, and then it's like new, waterproof. wise.
Yeah, you just let it dry on the hanger and then it's like new. Okay.
And then doesn't that mean that kind of like it's not the best quality in the first place? Because
what are you trying to say?
Plastic bag is waterproof. I don't know if the bloody coat.
But it wears out.
So this is the bit I don't get.
No, I've got images of Naaved being like putting a plastic bag over himself, like one of those IKEA bags.
It's not going to mess up my hair, that's for sure.
There is that.
Oh, I know that feeling.
My point is, it just seems a bit weird that you buy something that's waterproof and then you have to kind of re-waterproof it.
It's a maintenance thing.
What if you smothered yourself in this copy deck?
I want the coat to last.
Yeah, but what if you smothered yourself in this copy deck and then you don't even have to wear the coat?
I am waterproof anyway. I don't need to waterproof myself.
I go wrinkly if I've been down the water too long.
Yeah, exactly. So if you want to avoid going prune-like, you just smother yourself in copy decks.
Well, Jerry, you try it. It could be a whole new anti-aging treatment.
It could be. What is that before
could
aging?
Be. Yeah, before aging.
I've got to listen to either.
I think it's a bit late.
No, we haven't got there yet.
Oh, that's true.
That's true.
Oh dear. Right. If dogs could wear. I've put pants, but that's probably because I've copied it from an American, but especially underpants or trousers. How would they wear them?
One leg at a time.
So the question would be, does it go on all four legs halfway up the dog, or does it just go on the hind legs?
No, it's on the hind legs.
Because you wrote pants, I took the English version. So it's
and you've used pants.
Back legs only, with a hole for the tail. Done.
Tidy whities.
Whitey-tighties. Tidy whities.
There's no way it can be any other way. Otherwise you're talking underwear. All right, no, so otherwise you're talking trousers.
Yeah, but we're talking underwear.
We're talking underwear, so I'm going with... It covers the giblets and the hole, and there's a little...
Giblets.
Okay, maybe I said that wrong. The bollocks and the
cock. Thanks, love. Better.
Of forming bones, of giblets, of crushing teeth and...
Swinging.
Giblets was the wrong word.
Giblets.
Definitely. Bollocks was better.
Cover the bollocks. But it's got to be a hole in them. For the tail, because that ain't fair. Man.
Yeah, because that ain't fair. No, I'm with you with that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll go with that. Sorry, Dom.
No, this is even this answer is even better than what I expected. That's what I love about it. The thing is, right, I found these questions and I normally admit them, and Jerry's had a few, but the one I did with Samwise, I got absolutely slated for the type of questions that I came with. Like, absolutely, completely and utterly destroyed by everybody. And I thought, oh, I've got to try and keep these reasonably, like, sensible. But sometimes it's like, oh, is that actually going to give a good answer? But this is probably the best one. Did not expect to be talking about giblets, but that's...
It was both Tien's expression and Carey's expression. Carey that's like, oh crap, we're back here again. And then Tien just going, what? What?
Tien woke up. She's like, yeah, what?
What the hell?
not a good image.
Myself and Jerry disagree on this next one. Eyes open or eyes closed when at the dentist?
Open.
Closed.
I mean, look, she's looking in your fob, right? And she'll have the occasional glance to your eyes.
Why is the
she
dentist
needs to see the whites of my eyes. She needs to know that if she fucks up, I'm coming for it. She needs to see the crazy right there.
The crazy.
So not difficult.
An insurance policy.
You could probably see it if your eyes were closed. It's okay.
Yeah, crazy, yeah.
Well, I was at the dentist yesterday.
Curiosity.
I was at the dentist yesterday. I had a filling. Yeah. Eyes open.
Oh, no.
Eyes open. Curiosity.
Until the pain got to a point where it was unbearable. There were three moments where the pain was so bad.
That kind of... the nuts, did you?
Pain?
Yeah, pain.
We're back
even
here again.
Was even after the...
And the nuts, yeah.
And the nuts.
I was ignoring those.
Yeah, but I said, put your hand up if it gets too much. And I thought, right, okay. So there was pain, went to sort of about 7 or 8. And then every now and again, it went to an 11 out of 10, at which point I was going, hand. So I put up with about 3 of those. Because I didn't want the heavy duty injection. But yeah, the rest of the...
You didn't want the injection?
No. I got an injection, but apparently there's one that numbs your gum and basically the side of your face. There's one that completely numbs your jaw, your whole jaw, and it goes down to like bone
level. So you didn't want that?
I didn't want that one. Because the dentist said you don't really... You want to try and avoid that one because that will ruin your afternoon. And I said, yeah, let's not go for that one.
And now you're wishing you had.
No. I was all good. I was all good. I was in pain even last night, and I'm not in great shape at the moment. But yeah, but eyes open the whole way.
Open.
Yeah.
Why closed?
Just me and Tien.
It's just you and Tien,
then.
Yeah.
But why?
I don't want to see the disappointment in my dentist's face.
Oh, fair enough. Yeah, fair enough.
Again, I told you, floss, blah, blah, blah.
Did you floss? Can you not hear it in their voice, though?
Yeah, I'll try and drown that out as well.
Okay.
Just earplugs. Some magic FM that's playing in the background, you know.
So hang on, Tien. So what you're saying is even before the treatment, you just sit there with your eyes closed whilst the dentist is talking to you. Nice.
No, because normally, like, come in, sit in the chair. And you're saying, I've done everything you said, but I know that you're going to find something. Like, you see this tiny tooth here? You didn't brush that one enough. Are you doing your 2 minutes with your electric toothbrush? Yes. I forgot.
In the shower.
Are you doing that in the shower? No, or you need to be doing that in the shower?
Evidently, you need to do the Naaved technique. You need to be more aggressive.
More aggressive, yeah.
What can we say?
My dentist told me I was being too aggressive with brushing my teeth because it was like damaging my gums.
Mine too.
So I was like,
oh yeah. Wow.
Okay.
Do it in the shower.
I'll stop brushing my teeth in the shower.
And brush my teeth.
If you go in the, if you do in the shower, you'll be less aggressive because you feel everything going around.
I can't feel everything going around.
Can't do that.
Not a man.
Not a man.
Nothing slapping against
what are you saying?
Oh, good Lord.
Oh, I don't think he's going to help us.
No. No, he's looking down right now.
I'm not taking that any further.
Shaking his head.
No, it's. I will say definitely eyes closed. Definitely eyes closed.
Why?
Why?
Purely, I actually think it's more comfortable to, because holding your eyes open is effort and holding your jaw open is effort. I'm like, let me at least have one part of my face that's lazy, right? I'm not going to try and keep both like this. At least if I can, I can relax the top half of my face. And, you know, when the root canal is 2 hours, I'm like, I'm just going to make myself as comfortable as possible. Got the jaw pressed pride open, so just relax everything.
And is that how long it took, Dom?
Yeah, 2 hours.
2 hours?
Ow.
What the hell?
Yeah. Two hour root canal, 4 hour hip operation. What's next?
I know, literally all within like a week.
The hip.
Well, it should have only been an hour and a half.
Oh, okay. So, fair enough.
So it took a long time to do my hip, a lot longer than it should have done. And the 15 minutes it took to pry open my hip and get in there. That's all good.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Right. Why are pizzas round? Now, there's probably an answer to this, but I'm
there
curious.
There is an answer to it. And I know what it is, but you can go and evade.
Oh.
Pizzas are round in order to make sure that they cook evenly.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they cook it evenly, and it's easier to cut something that's a circle than a different shape. Make even slices.
So I looked it up and I got the same answer, but I also got that in 1984, the Associazione Universale Pizza di Napolavino, or the True Neapolitan Pizza Association, declared that a specific set of rules for an authentic pizza, and these rules include that a pizza must not exceed a diameter of 13.7 inches. Diameter means that they have to be round.
Yeah, it does.
So there you go. That's the official rules.
It's what happens when you give us questions and we do homework. But we lost Dom again.
Have we worked out who the SWATs are now?
Yeah.
The nerds.
It's Naaved. It's Naaved.
We're narrowing it down.
Look it up. I just
like. I didn't look it up either.
You rely on me to do that normally, yeah, Jerry.
Basically, because we go straight to Google.
I suppose then the question would be, would they taste worse if they were square?
Yeah,
because they won't be cooked as well.
I had one in Boston. And
a square one?
To be fair, it was rectangular as opposed to square. So oblong, which is, so it was an oblong, because that's the baking tray it came in. And you had to be able... There was this thing in the bar in Boston where if you ate the whole thing on your own, then you'd get your picture taken and go up on the wall. And you'd get a picture of free beer. So I did it. And somewhere in Boston in a bar, not far from a Yale, is my picture in a bar early in the pizza that was big and oblong. And I drank the whole picture of my beer by myself. Because my friends wouldn't actually eat the pizza themselves. So they wouldn't have one themselves, but they wanted to share my beer. So I told them to do one. I had the picture as well. And I have to say, in answer to the question, the corners, too crispy in comparison to the rest.
It's stodgy in the middle.
Yeah.
It's like the brownies, isn't it? If you make a... You make a square tray of brownies, you always get the crispy brownies on the end and the stodgy ones in the middle.
True.
And people have a fight. Some people have different preferences, but you get a fight for getting the better bit of the brownie, I suppose.
I'd fight for the middle.
Middle.
Edge.
Stodgy middle brownies.
Tien's the baker.
I made some brownies yesterday. I didn't make brownies, I made blondies yesterday. Yesterday? Tuesday, I made blondies. They went to Matt's.
What's
work.
Blondies?
They're just brownies, but not with chocolate in them. White chocolate.
Oh, that'd be nice.
And which is the best bit?
I don't know. I don't eat any of my baking.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
why?
She's saying that, but I don't understand. You don't even taste it.
No.
Why don't you eat any of your baking? You're a really good baker.
I don't really like too many sweet things, so but I enjoy the therapy of baking. So Matt's colleagues get the benefit of it. So every Monday he takes them to work. In this case it was Wednesday.
I've got to say the recipe you gave me for that focaccia.
Focaccia's gorgeous.
Yeah, that looked amazing.
My kids love it.
It is.
Everybody loves it. It's really good. So thanks for that.
We're going to sourdough next.
Are we?
I'll do that.
I thought we were going to cinnamon buns.
Oh, yeah, cinnamon buns next.
No. I don't want sweet stuff. Go on, give me the bread.
Need to get Laura on Jerry again.
Oh, God, yeah, have a bake-off. You have a bake-off.
We could have a bake-off.
Oh, that'd be interesting because Laura's very good.
Yeah. When we weren't.
We didn't say we were good.
Well, Laura's good. We've seen some of her handiwork, haven't we? Yeah.
I've had some of them.
That's
not a phrasing now. I was going to say that's a really bad phrasing. I could take that back. My friends are going to go mental. God. Speak to a brother-in-law as well. moving on. What is the most underrated and the most overrated holiday?
Day.
By holiday, we're talking about days that are like bank holidays, days that you buy cards for, those kind of things.
Yeah. Generic kind of holiday days, whether that's Christmas, Easter, ooh. Remembrance Day.
Is that not what you went with?
No, I was thinking, I thought something totally different.
Holiday.
Yeah, what is the, you know, most underrated day that you
destination
can have on a holiday anywhere?
Overrated.
But I didn't think you meant like a day of the year.
Well, I'm happy for your answer as well, Naaved. I think that's great. I'm open to interpretation.
Yeah.
So my most overrated is a day in Los Angeles or San Francisco. People are assholes, they're up there in arses. If you've got any listeners from out there, I do apologise to them profusely. I'm sure they're very nice, but everybody else is a wanker. And they're up there in arses with their...
There are more court cases.
Yeah.
What it's like. You know.
Yeah, no, I do.
City of Los Angeles. Is denied.
Yeah. The city of Los Angeles versus Naaved.
I mean, I don't mind other places in the US. It's just, basically, they're up there in arses and they think they're all cool, and actually they're not. They're a bunch of dicks.
There's a lot of influencers in Los Angeles as well.
There's a lot of what?
That's true.
Influencers.
Yeah, well, exactly. There you go. What better bloody influences? They should drop a bomb on the bloody place. Seriously. I'm not joking. Yeah, I think that is the most overrated. There's nothing to see. You're likely to get stabbed in one of them, mugged in the other. And if it's not that, you'll be carjacked. I remember I walked down the street in Hollywood. I mean, it was quite a few years ago. And I got stopped for no reason whatsoever. Where are you going, sir? Like, what do you mean, where am I going? I'm walking down the street. And then I got told that I had to go home. I was like, you are f***ing by a policeman. Because I was walking down the street, minding my own damn business. So yeah, overrated crap.
Okay.
Fair enough.
And I'm very curious about what your underrated is now.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Underrated, what I really think would be is well worth doing, and again, a long time ago, is motorbiking in Cuba. Off the beaten track. So go to Varadero and then make your own way to, say, Havana or somewhere else on a bike. Everybody, despite the fact that, you know, people in, especially the US, have painted this picture that it's all bleak. Everybody's really happy. Food's not great, but coffee's amazing. They have cigars that are fat and amazing too. And it's just, the countryside is beautiful. You've got the sea, you can smell the sea breeze from everywhere. The roads aren't the best, but you don't go fast on a bike. There is no point, but really, really enjoyable. Well worth doing.
Wow. I mean,
I remember when you went there.
Yeah. I mean, we started on a scooter, but I have a motorbike ride license, so I did say, right, okay, let's upgrade and be more comfortable. And so we did that, and it was just so much better. It was just great.
Amazing.
Wow. Okay.
I'm jealous.
God's gonna make mine sound dreadful now, because I've done holiday days, as in holiday days, not as in holidays.
But I can do that too off the top of my head. But let's go with you.
Go on then. All right. The most overrated holiday is probably Mother's Day. You know, why take a day to do Mother's Day? If you want to be nice to your mum, be nice to your mum.
Oh, but it's got a religious background, hasn't it?
I don't care.
Yeah, but is it a holiday day? Because it's always a Sunday.
Yeah, because
it's a holiday day.
It's a holiday day. Okay.
It's still a holiday day. It does
have history. Father's Day was invented by card companies, right? Mother's Day came right from, you know, the God Squad.
Did it?
Yeah, because of the good old Virgin Mary. Yeah. Sorry, Tien.
Fair enough, but I still think it's massively overrated and massively hyped for what it is. And I say, if you want to celebrate your mum, celebrate your mum. Don't wait till a specific day in the year to do it.
Bit like Valentine's Day.
Yeah, we can go there as well. Yeah.
Well, we know what the end.
We know where we're going with that one. Underrated day. I love New Year's Eve. I always have loved New Year's Eve. It's got very special meaning to me, with my dad having been Scottish, and we always went to a Cayley, and we always hung out with friends, and we always got drunk. And so it goes back a long time with me. I absolutely love it, and I think it's better than Christmas if you do it right. But I know how much Jerry hates Christmas.
Yeah, let's not go there.
That wouldn't be difficult.
Yeah, but interesting enough, I didn't choose Christmas. I chose New Year's Day. Because I just thought, okay, a day when you actually have to take time off because it's a holiday day. So I chose New Year's Day because it's only one day. And then you're back at work.
Yeah.
And that sucks.
Work in a school.
Yeah, I was about to say.
But
work in a school.
Yeah, but...
not back till the 6th of January.
Oh, yeah, that'll be fine. Yeah, we can do that.
And if you don't work in a school, then basically your New Year's Day, you're hungover.
Basically, I don't care because you get to live holidays
in,
the rest
live
of the
in
year.
Scotland.
Well, yeah, Scotland.
Live in Scotland, you get the second off.
Right. So the Scots have got it right.
That's only because they've drunk so much on New Year's Eve that they need 2 days.
This is very true.
That's the whole point, though, isn't that's it?
That's the whole point.
Tien?
Oh, dear.
Obviously, Valentine's Day, super overrated. I don't care. Obviously, happily married and all of that. So we don't really need a day to remind each other, I hope. I'll check later.
Dom?
Oh, I was going to say Valentine's Day as well, I think is overrated. That's my that's my overrated choice. I'm single, so I don't have to celebrate it, which is wonderful. Overrated, definitely Valentine's Day. I'm with you on that one, Tien.
If I had to choose a day as opposed to
a holiday.
Yeah. I'd go for in America, I'd go for Thanksgiving.
We're not American.
What?
I know, but you know, it's a holiday day.
I'll pick President's
Day. Holiday day.
Yeah, but I would have done Father's Day, but Mother's Day, and it's a bit, you know. I would have said Valentine's Day as well. You know, I like Easter, I like Christmas, blah blah blah. I think the paraphernalia around those, you know, like the fat man with the beard molesting children, breaking and entering,
breaking and entering.
So that guy is all overrated. But I think if I look at it, I think Thanksgiving is probably one of the worst, because aren't they giving thanks for raping the land and kicking the indigenous people off it and now chucking them to a side? Isn't that what Thanksgiving is about? Everyone give thanks for that?
Yep. Yeah.
It is. I can agree. I think it's massively overhyped as well, because they don't. Isn't that the one where they get like the president has to like kill a turkey or something?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it part of? There's a whole ritual behind
a turkey
it.
So now we.
And also, turkey is probably the worst bird to have at a roast, so to speak.
So now we've got the American tourist board versus Naaved. Another court case.
I'm already banned from America. I might have done that. I might have annoyed TSA the other week, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'll tell that in a bit. Most underrated, then. New Year's Eve. I've got a really one that will probably take it. Pancake Day.
Ooh.
Definitely underrated.
Yeah, I think I'm with you on that, Dom. Yeah. I agree, actually. It's so overlooked. Yeah.
And because I made the pancakes I made this year, so thickish pancakes, slightly fluffy, and then you have vanilla ice cream drizzled with Biscoff spread.
Oh,
see, I'm not with the Biscoff.
Oh, really?
Biscoff is like
Biscoff
the.
Is yummy.
Oh. No.
That's like type 2 diabetes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But I prefer the thin ones. I make the
thin pancakes.
Yeah.
I just love pancakes. It could be either. Just give me part of my pancakes. I think they're so underrated.
Yeah. You are right. It is overlooked, actually, quite a lot.
We'll all go for that one. We didn't do Pancake Day this year because Noah was on a school trip. So.
Yeah, he would have been off, yeah. Because it was just after we were in York.
My story on how I managed to annoy the TSA last week. So I went to Florida about this time last year in February and had the worst experience of my life trying to get through American customs. Oh, I just don't understand how you can organize something so badly in my life. So flew into JFK and needed to get a connecting flight to Florida. Note to self, fly direct last time. Got to JFK airport and then stood in a queue that kind of went like this, like those, you get those like cinema bar, typical things you get in airport, all the way around. And you got there and it said, right, the queue is over an hour long. And I'm thinking, oh God, okay, fine. But we've got 3.5 hours till our connecting flight. So 3 hours, 15 minutes later, we made it to the front of the queue.
Oh my God.
And there was like hundreds of us and there's 50 booths, 50 booths. And they had four open. And then we got to the front and the bloke just went, right, I'm done, and closed his booth. I'm like, I'm gonna go mental. So like eventually another one opened, we went through, and my coach, because it was taekwondo, my coach went through first and he found our bags, which had obviously gone through probably about 3 hours ago. We then went to have them deposit them in the next plane, and this really large American come forward, is a bit obnoxious. Oh, make sure you've got at least an hour to your connecting flight. Well, we had like 20 minutes left at this point. And I went, we don't, but no thanks to your airport, and just gave him the bags and just walked off. Worst bit is I didn't drink anything during that entire 3 hours, because you're stood in a queue for 3 hours. You don't want to be drinking water. And I thought, right, I'll have a drink of water. No, I had to go through another set of security gates. So guess where my water had to go? Into the bin.
No.
So I raised a complaint. I said like that was ridiculous, and I actually raised a complaint against against the airport. And the airport came back to me a year later. They came back to me. They said, we're terribly sorry, your email didn't get through to us. This is a problem with TSA. You need to take up the complaint with them. So I put a complaint into, and they sent me a link, which I thought was quite handy. So I put a complaint into TSA and they went, your complaint doesn't run with us, it goes with the airport. So I got them both together. I emailed them both at the same time and I went, you're all both just shit. I just put that on the email and went, thank kind regards, a British citizen, and just sent it.
Oh, brilliant.
Not had a response to that.
Brilliant.
One.
Brilliant. Oh, you have to wait a year.
Yeah, probably. So, yes. Yes, that is my America story, and why I also agree with Naaved, America is very overrated.
Yep, definitely so.
Right, on to the last couple of sections then. We want to take away some movies. At some point, we're going to do a movie review podcast, which me and Jerry are going to have to carefully research. But we want some movies from you three on what that we should watch. Now, it doesn't matter if Jerry's already seen them, but I probably haven't, I think is the rule number one, that is. So who wants to give a movie that we need to watch and review in a later podcast first?
Do we have to give four? You put four on the list.
No, one each.
No, one.
Oh,
no.
One each. I picked four.
Well, you can have one of mine then.
I picked six.
I did one. I was told to do one.
No,
I did
no,
one.
Movie choice one, movie choice two, movie choice three, and I've
got... I put them in order. That was four. It's like a ranking.
That's because it's four.
Oh, yeah, because it's Slarty as well, wasn't it?
Slarty, yeah.
I've got two.
We know what he would pick.
Between two number fours.
What would Slarty
he picked,
pick?
Two number fours.
What did he pick? He picked Rocky Horror Show.
Rocky Horror Show.
Oh, God.
Which I haven't seen.
But I can't choose one. This is like room 101. I can't choose one thing to talk about. I couldn't choose one either, but I had to.
No,
I can't pick one. Life is full of options. Okay, it's like a menu. If a menu had one thing, I wouldn't go to a f***ing restaurant, would I?
No, that's true. Yeah, that's true.
So there you go.
Well, I mean,
we'll
you've
go
got to read the list out and I'll type as quickly as I can.
Okay. Number one on my list was 1982's Blade Runner.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good choice.
Yeah.
Which, And the reason that it's amazing is because it actually, when Philip K. Dick did see some of the special effects in it, he said, that's what I imagined in my head.
Oh, it's amazing. Really amazing.
Yeah. I think that's amazing.
Yeah, worth seeing.
Then the next two, and my movie choice number two, were Inception, 2010.
Yeah,
and Interstellar,
that's good.
2014.
Yeah.
I missed the second one.
I missed the second one. What's the second one? Inception and
second one.
Interstellar.
Interstellar.
Okay. So both Christopher Nolan. The first one is obviously Ridley Scott. My choice number three, which is just one film, Tien might like, is the 1986 The Name of the Rose.
Which, oh, I love it.
Also my favourite book of all time by Umberto Eco, and actually I think the film caught the book really, really well.
And it, nice and eye candy.
In Carey, it's got Christian Slater in it, okay?
Yeah, exactly. Nice eye candy.
Slater.
Very important.
I'll make sure to have that. On my review.
Slater.
Some of us had a life-size poster of Christian Slater.
Life-size?
Some of us.
Oh, yes.
I won't ask what you did with that.
Sorry, Naaved. I'm not telling you.
Did it go in the shower?
Now we're all just imagining.
No, we're not going back to that. Exactly, that's fine.
I think it ended up in the shower.
No, I've still got it.
Toothbrush.
Yeah, okay. Ah, but did you cover it in copy decks?
No.
Before you took it into the shower?
I can't do my joke, because my joke is way too rude.
No, it's fine.
My joke was going to be, was it the electric toothbrush that was buzzing? That was the
question.
Ooh. We are not going there. No way. No way.
Naaved, next one, quick, go.
Okay, so choice number four.
Number four.
I've got two at number four. One was Monty Python's Life of Brian, 1979, which I love because actually there's so many truths in there about my views on religion, at least. The other classic is The Lady Killers, 1955.
Love it.
Absolutely amazing. It's so beautifully done. Black and white. Is it black and white?
Yeah, it's black and white.
It's kind of a sepia kind of thing. But yeah, I really like that. So they're my six films in movie choices 1, 2, 3. A man that cannot follow instructions and clearly cannot.
He's gone off beast. Yeah.
Sorry, love.
That's
it.
Not unusual.
No, that's true.
Oh dear. Tien, do you want to give us the four that you've got?
I've got seven.
Seven, yeah.
Have you seriously? Carey, that's when you go, I've got eight.
I've got one.
You followed
instructions.
Naaved is going to have the same reaction to my list as I've just had to his, because it is the complete antithesis of all his very serious movies.
Is it not anti-pasta?
It is anti,
yeah.
Anti-movies. So the first one you've already had on one of your other podcasts, which is The Princess Bride, which is, I put it number one, it is my all-time favourite film. And I will watch it every single time.
Fantastic film.
I love it. That film so much.
And eye candy, but love it.
At number two, Naaved's like, oh my God, I have put Strictly Ballroom.
Love that. Yes, Baz Luhrmann.
It's hilarious. Just funny.
It's fantastic.
And silly. And I don't think it ages. So all good.
No, it's good.
I then, because I'll only pick two more because of four. I'll stick to four. I had a slight obsession growing up, not with Christian Slater, but with River Phoenix.
Ooh,
so okay. My films are Stand By Me, because that was when Young River. Good. And then My Own Private Idaho, which is just before. But also has Keanu Reeves in it. It's just,
this is true.
It does, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's still, no, I can't get with that one.
One of your four I like. The rest, Venom.
Which one do you like?
Stand by me.
Stand By Me.
Amazing, that was.
Princess Bride is great.
Princess Bride is the ultimate movie.
Love it.
Inconceivable.
It's just great.
Fair enough.
You need to watch it.
Carey, do you want to give us your... Have you not watched it, Naaved?
I have. Don't ever want to see it again. Well, I don't want to see an advert for it.
I don't even want to see an advert for it.
Fuck that. Somebody shows me the poster for it, I'll set it on fire.
Do you know what's coming your way?
Well, I've got one of those.
And in our WhatsApp group, you're going to get so many Princess Bride memes. Now.
So many gifts.
You're going to get so many. Every day.
If you're going to... Right, every day. We're going to have to do a gold member reference back.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. No, that film does not come in my house.
Oh, Dr. Evil. Can I paint this you who gold? It's kind of my thing, you know?
Stop it.
It's got 8 out of 10 on IMDb.
That's because it's amazing.
No way.
Let's not start that.
1987.
My God, 87. I didn't realise it was that.
87?
Wow.
I can't believe that it's that. It's got that good. Oh, my God. It's got nobody fucking famous in it either.
It's got Carey Alls in it.
Who?
Oh, and Robin Wright.
Who?
Oh, yeah, it's got Billy Crystal. It's not got that many. I mean, come on, really? I mean, really?
Yes, really.
I mean, Princess, Interstellar, Homeboy. Really?
Come to think of it. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, God.
Carey, are you going to save the segment?
I'm going to go for Stardust. Stardust. And if you haven't seen it, you need to.
Is that with Robert De Niro?
No.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Robert De Niro's in it.
He wears a dress and everything.
Which Stardust? Oh, yes. The 2021?
No, it'd be the OG Stardust.
No.
Yeah. The 2007.
2007.
2007, is it?
Why is everyone on Google?
Well, I'm like,
it's got Henry Cavill in it.
Yes, it has.
So who's that?
Henry Cavill.
Oh, yeah. Is it really?
Charlie Cox.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
He's a pretty human, isn't he?
He's also eye candy.
Oh,
to be
yes.
Fair,
we could
he?
Go for that. Eye candy, yeah.
It's got Sienna Miller as well.
It has.
Okay,
yeah.
A cow.
Sorry.
Little bit of eye candy for you. Cow. Her character isn't great, but, yeah.
Okay, it's
got Claire Danes in it.
I can't comment because I don't think I've seen it.
Claire Danes is in Homeland. She in Homeland.
Oh, and Romeo plus Juliet.
Yes.
The bit that's ironic for me is I'm on IMDb and it says More Like This, and the first film in the list on More Like This.
The Princess Bride.
The Princess Bride.
No way.
Yeah.
What the Fringe?
Okay, well I ain't gonna watch this.
What the Fringe?
The actual Fringe.
Naaved, I think I'm going to love it.
No, it's good.
No,
you'll like it,
Naaved. Your girls would love it. And
your
the Princess Bride.
No.
Come up here, you can come and watch it.
I tell you what, just to be fair, right? My girls have seen a lot of that, you know, kind of Disney crap and all the rest of it.
It's not
right?
Disney crap.
I know. I've seen when they were growing up. But
is that another lawsuit, I hear?
What?
Naaved versus Disney.
Another lawsuit coming.
Yes.
Okay, I've got a story about Disney, right? But I recently showed, actually a while ago, showed my eldest one of Christopher Nolan's early films with Guy Pearce in it, but he did himself. I can't remember what it's called.
Yep.
And she loved it, and then she wanted to see all the others. She was blown away by Inception,
Is that
Inception.
Memento? Is it Memento?
So they're into some really hardcore thinking kind of films. But the story that I have about Disney was when they did Frozen, right? And you know the song, Let It Go, that song?
Yes.
Right? So I'm in the supermarket with my two girls, right? And they're a lot younger then. And Mihika picked some ham out, it was M&S, and she said, "Dada, can we have this, please?" and she was holding it, and it was like vaguely over the trolley, and I said, let it go, put it in the trolley. We love ham, we love eggs, there will be jolly. And I just kept on going, and everything I looked at seemed to rhyme with it. And I did the whole damn verse, you know, I don't care if it's ham or bread or whatever it was. And we were just giggling. We were like, we're in our own world. We get to the till, and the lady's putting it through on the little scanner thingy, and one of my daughters is packing, and this guy's walking over to me in a suit, and he's looking at me, and I'm thinking, what the f***? Have one of my kids stolen something? And he walks over, and he said, sir. And then from behind his back, he pulls out a little bag, and he said, the staff would like to present you with this, because nobody has heard a rendition of Frozen quite like that. Staff, nor customers. And they were chocolate truffles, and my kids looked up at me like, he's my hero.
Nice. I think they're dropping the lawsuit now.
Yeah.
Possibly. They haven't heard the song.
And sing every day. Man. No, I've got to be busting. Yeah. Busting outside of M&S.
Oh, dear. Well, we've come to the end of the podcast.
Wow.
Thank you very much for being on it. Thank you. There is one section that Jerry always forgets.
Don't worry. Well, there's two bits, two things.
Final thoughts.
Well, no, are we doing Celebrity Call-Out Corner? Two things. We've got to do this.
We can do Celebrity Call-Out Corner.
I'm going to do a special Celebrity Call-Out Corner, and this is dedicated to you, Carey. So it's we've got to do the jingle, haven't we? Spoiler alert. Celebrity. Celebrity Call-Out Corner. So, yeah, it's going to be... it's got to be Christian Slater. So,
oh yes, please.
If you are listening to this, Christian or Mr. Slater, however you'd like to be, whatever you'd like to be called, Mr. Slater. Mr. C. Slater,
freaking Hot Fuzz now,
or
I did that Staker, but that was. Sick.
Or if there's anyone that, well, then we're not going back to the toothbrush again, or copy decks, if. If you know, if there's anybody listening to this who knows Christian Slater, either directly or indirectly, or if you're the agent of Christian Slater and anybody knows the agent of Christian Slater, either directly or indirectly, please reach out to us. It'll be great to have you as a guest. And Carey, well, you're all invited back on, but Carey, we'll let you know, have your list of questions ready, put your copy decks away. You won't need it.
I'll dig the poster out.
Dig the poster out. Yeah, you've got to have that in the background.
Make sure the electric toothbrush stays in the bathroom.
Oh, my God.
You watch yourself.
Oh, dear. As Jerry would say, we'll burrito that and get everybody's final thoughts.
Yeah, but it can't start with me. We're going to start with...
No.
Naaved, final thoughts.
Who would like to go...
Final thoughts on what?
On what?
Anything, life? Just final thoughts. Anything. What are your final thoughts?
What my final thoughts are like? My final thoughts are like six trains all on the same track, or two tracks about to collide with each other, with four drivers, and all of them screaming, and that's it.
What?
Do you think this is why we needed the
tested for ADHD before?
What? What the hell? Yeah. No, I was thinking more like Jerry Springer, you know, take...
Oh, just... okay, then all right. So my final thought is... My final
train wrecks.
I think genuinely, it'd be a piece of advice for everyone, and that's don't get clothes dry because your shirts will not come out clean.
Excellent. I think that's fair.
Good advice. Gonna say, yeah. In the shower whilst you're brushing your
shower. Yeah.
No, I'm past the shower and the brushing thing. Dryer wants to do everything all at once. So.
Yeah. There you go.
Same time.
Yeah.
Jerry was doing it.
Oh dear. Tien.
Well, maybe it will be. Don't in the shower while you're trying to brush your teeth. Like, I don't have any deep thoughts at the moment. Other than this was super good fun. But I'm really, really hungry now. So my final thoughts
are... Yeah, I bet you are.
I'm going to have my dinner in a minute.
Yeah.
Cool. Carey?
I don't really have any final thoughts. But, you know, we should do this again.
Yeah, I'd love to.
Absolutely.
I don't think Dom can cope.
cope. Yeah. No.
I'm not prepared now, right? I can prepare myself.
I'm a little bit...
No one can prepare themselves on.
If your, I don't know, listening or viewing figures reduce as a result of this, then I suspect we won't be doing it again.
We blame Jerry.
That said, we'd very much like to do it again because it's been a lot of fun. Even if it completely has destroyed your reputation. And sorry, apologise to your mother in advance.
Yeah.
We would love to do it again.
The legend that
the
is.
The legend.
No, I definitely would love to have you. What would be really interesting is when we eventually get set up to be able to do an in-person one.
Oh my God.
But some spoiler alerts for that. Jerry, your final
thoughts? My final thoughts is, Slarty, you'd better make the next one.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's my final thought.
You keep ducking out. What's that about?
Seriously? Mm.
Actually, here's one. Do you reckon we could get Phil on?
Oh, that'd be good.
Yeah, we can get Phil on.
Yeah.
Yeah, it just has to fit with her shifts.
Yeah, but I think we should try that. Yeah. That'd be very
good. God, yeah, we'd get Phil on.
Phil and Slarty. Okay.
And don't final thoughts from you. Everyone's crush that
we've ever known. Yeah, everyone's crush. Yeah.
And I've forgotten her name now. This is really bad. Who is it that you sent me the photo of? Charlotte.
Christine. Yeah, that's a different story.
That is a different story.
Oh, I want it on the next
that
podcast.
That is a different story.
Yeah, that's a different story.
That is a different story.
Well, this is the exact reason why I invite my friends on individually. Then they can't gang up on me.
Exactly.
That is my final thoughts. And it is why I have some friends that will never meet.
Oh, now that's a shame. Life.
Don't cross the beams.
So thank you so much for coming on. I have really enjoyed this evening. Evidently, my PC couldn't handle it, so that'll be interesting. I don't think we've lost anything, so that's all good. Dear listeners, thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for listening. And we'll catch you on the next podcast.
Bye. Take care, everyone. Bye.
Bye-bye.